thank the Honorable Prime Minister for giving his time and coming here and joining us and participating in this event when we have the first award ceremony in the history of this institute. So you will go down in history, sir, as part of our very beginnings. And we are very grateful to you for having decided at that time to hand over this land back to the church after it was taken over in the 60s as part of the Catholic Training College, which existed here many years before that. And when Honorable Sir, I know your personal involvement and interest in the matter of education. And we are grateful to you for that. And I've had a number of discussions with you, and you have mentioned to me a number of times the importance of stressing on employment education, education for employment, so that our youth will be given the opportunity to have some career guidance and help. In 1971, as we know, we had the first youth rebellion, say, and then another 15, 16 years later, we had another one in the 1980s, when this country was swamped by a lot of violence and an incredible amount of suffering for the people. It is always necessary that we educate our youth to a disciplined existence and also to help them to move forward in life. It is true that we have many institutes of higher education today in Sri Lanka compared with a few years, a few decades ago. But all the same, what is important is that education is mixed with personality formation. If the human being, that is the student, does not realize the importance of his person's life, because you may have all the knowledge of the sciences, but if you are not a human being who is a dignified human being, who is aware of his own dignity and his greatness and can contribute to society in this sense, then the education process is a failure. I think it is important often.
You need managerial skills, you need middle level skills, you need language skills. It's not merely a question of having unskilled workers or semi-skilled staff. If you have to run hotels, if you have to run tourism, we need the skills. We need those language skills. We need chefs who will know how to prepare the food. We need the IT, whether it be manufacturing, whether it be services, in any sector. We need these skills to expand. And one of the biggest tasks, both the government and the non-government sector has to do, is how to provide. Because you need a large number of skills. It's not like the school system. You tell everyone to go in to sit for the O-level. That's the exam for all. Here, there are so many different types of jobs. So many skills. For some, there will be thousands of accountants who are needed. For some, there will only be a few. So it's these institutions which have to look at the job market skills, what is required, and then you train people. When investors come to Sri Lanka, they will look at the availability of skills. And we have a rapid program of urbanization of the western province, Viamba, which will call for large economic zones of industries, of IT, of Hambantota. We are turning out land, we are identifying land for the zones for investors to come in, a large number of hotels, because we have to create jobs and good jobs for the young people of this country. We all have ambitions and aspirations, not very big ones, just to get a good education, get a good income, get a vehicle, at least a motor bicycle, if you can't buy a car, to find a house, to get to marry, to have children, to be able to pay your hand, have a mobile phone, to listen to your music. Now it's easy. your TV, your music, everything comes in one iPad. So you haven't got to be having three or four different instruments in the house. But this is the desire of consumer society. Now, there are people who say a consumer society is not good, those who say they are good. Fact is, it's a consumer society. And this is what people want when they are living. All these young people here want to get ahead in life. Now, if you don't want to get ahead in life, Sri Lanka won't get ahead. It's your ambition to get ahead in life, to start businesses, to go on, that has to be encouraged. All legitimate endeavors must be encouraged and applauded. But to do that, you need the education institutions. So we are also looking at how we could, we are now considering how we can work hand in hand with some of these private institutions. I need not tell you the problems that we have in the school sector. We haven't got enough teachers, and we only teach A-level science and maths in a limited number of schools. We want to expand. So we decided that we will get another 2,000 science graduates and maths graduates. Now you can't get this to the national university system. Because if you are selected, you go in there, and when you leave, you can either come and take to teaching, which very few do, or go for any other jobs. So we have now decided that the government will, and the provincial council, there are 10 ministries in charge, we will recruit A-level people are qualified in A-levels who have got the minimum qualifications to do a degree. We give them a chance of joining the teaching service. And while teaching, they'll also be allowed to do a degree. We have already spoken with some other degree awarding institutes in the private sector. And they are willing to take them on. And we'll have a separate syllabus, so they may not be able to do the degree in 3 years. They'll have to teach. We need teachers. But while teaching, they'll also study. And finally, we'll have them coming out as graduates. 2,000 new science and maths graduates. That means more schools will have science and maths. There are many other fields we are looking at. We are looking in the field of English. We are focusing on that. How do we train trainers? How can we get English teachers? So there are many areas in which we could line up, we could certainly come to an agreement with this institute and the Aquinas, if you are prepared to help us and get the necessary people for English. We started, I think the last government started in centers for computers in schools. At the moment, we have nearly 500 vacancies. You have the computers, you have the teachers. And computers are not like wine, which can age and become better. Computers, unfortunately, as the years go by, go to waste. So now we are wondering, how can we get 500 instructors, full-time or part-time, into the school system to utilize these computers, to give the computer skills to students who can then come here, learn further.
Schools passing and deploying teachers for O-levels and A-levels is not sufficient anymore for employability. We have to have all, we must ensure that all young people are trained for employment and they have the opportunity as they go along in life to acquire more skills, to get more, to have more professional certificates and education, for which I hope the employers will make provision. So let me again thank His Eminence the Cardinal for this new institution, and wish you all the best. And I hope as we prosper, it won't be 6,000, it will be much more. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Honorable Rani Vikramasinghe, the Prime Minister of the Socialist Republic of Sri Lanka. And next, I invite Ms. Dinusha Fernando to deliver the word of thanks.
We thank our Blessed Mother, Our Lady of Lanka, for her intercession and guidance towards the BCI family. Honorable Prime Minister, thank you very much for gracing the occasion. We feel deeply honored by your presence and we are grateful and encouraged by your inspiring address. His Eminence Malcolm Cardinal Ranjit has been the driving force behind the whole initiative. Your vision, interest and hard work has once again culminated in another success story. I wish to thank you for the efforts you put in taking BCI towards a broader goal.